Hey y'all, and welcome to Spare Room. I'm Karen Terry, and today we're going to talk about Discord RPG rules. So this is part three of our running a Discord RPG series the way that I run them. So before we talked about roles and we talked about channels. So if you haven't seen those videos, I recommend going and watching those. I'll link those up in the card to make sure that you've had a chance to go see them. This one's going to make a lot more sense if you have watched those videos first. This time, we're going to talk about what rules you might want to set up in your Discord RPG. Now, I have talked before about my top 10 rules for any RPG, but in addition to those rules, what we want to have also is rules that help us roleplay on the particular platform that we've chosen to roleplay on, in this case, Discord. So let's jump into the first one, which is how to reply. So if you remember from my channel video, we talked about all of the different roleplay channels that I have set up in my Discord server. So when you're posting in those channels, what you need to do is at the bottom of your post, at the person that needs to reply next. And this way, everyone knows who's supposed to reply next. It's really easy then to go find your replies, and it's really easy to figure out what exactly is supposed to happen in the thread and what's expected. And it makes sure that threads don't get lost as easily. The next rule is about starting. We've got this channel called Plot and Starter Calls, and whenever you want to write a new starter, what you do is post in there and let people leave you emojis. So I'm showing an example up on screen here. This is a starter call that I wrote, and you can see it's got two emojis. So what that means is I need to go into two separate roleplay channels and write two different starters for the two people that left these emojis on this starter call. So one of those starters is going to add one of the people, and the other one is going to add the other one. Also, we want to keep things nice and organized. So the next Discord RPG rule that I have goes like this. I'm going to read it to you. If someone is already doing a thread in a channel you want, please do not jump in. We want to keep everything tidy and easy to understand. Instead, contact the mods to make another channel for you. Currently, it is not possible on Discord to let members make channels, so we're happy to make as many channels as members need. So what this means is you should only write starters in channels that aren't currently being used. So when you're done with a thread, like it's at the end, you'll put like thread end or thread dropped or whatever the case may be. It doesn't matter, so long as it's clear that you're not currently using the channel anymore. And then when you're ready to write new starters, what you do is click through the roleplay channels and find ones where the last message is a message like that. So you know no one's currently using the channel and you can jump in and put your starter in that channel. Now, if you can't find a channel that you want to put your starter in, all you have to do is post in the Contact the Mods channel. And what we'll do is either help you find a channel to put it in, or we'll make a new one. And the reason for this is because in Discord, if we allow people to create channels, they're also allowed to delete channels. So we can't allow regular members to create channels because then they would be allowed to delete them too. And that's probably just not a good idea. We also have a bubble role-playing rule. What bubble role-playing is when you're in a group and what you do is consistently only role-play with certain people and deny other people threads. And of course, because this is a group, we want to discourage that behavior. Now, that's not to say that you have to roleplay with everyone or that you have to roleplay with a certain character, but that is to say, if we notice you consistently avoiding certain characters or certain people, we're probably going to say something to you to find out what's going on. So remember this because it's going to be important in just a bit when we talk about the next Discord rule. The other thing we do in relation to Discord roleplays is what's called a stale thread check. So for that stale thread check, essentially what we do is if you haven't replied to a thread within 7 days, which 7 days is our activity rule, we consider that thread stale. And what we'll do is post a reminder to say, hey, it's your turn, go reply to this thread. Now, most people, when it comes to stale threads, it was purely an accident. They meant to reply and didn't. So as soon as that warning goes up, they'll go reply. But sometimes it's not on accident, unfortunately. So here's what that looks like. It says, the following threads are stale. This means they have not been replied to within the last 7 days. To ensure channels are not being hoarded and bubble RP isn't occurring, if you're tagged, please either reply or drop the thread ASAP. And then we tag all the specific channels and people that are doing this for that week. So, as we said, most of the time this is an accident, but sometimes it's not. So, for the instances where it's not, we have a rule that says if you get tagged in the same stale thread 3 weeks in a row, it's considered bubble role-playing. And we have a 3-strike system in my roleplay. So essentially the first time it happens, you just get a warning and then no action is really gonna be taken until you get to that 3rd strike. So you get a warning, 1, 2, and then it would be 3 and you'd be removed from the roleplay for bubble roleplaying. Now I have never had to remove someone for this. Almost always either 1 warning works or maybe 1 warning and a strike and the person either corrects the behavior or they end up realizing this isn't going to work out and they leave the role play at that point. So never had to get all the way to 3 strikes and kicking someone out for this. They pretty much will kick themselves when they realize that this role play isn't going to work for them. So if you remember back to the channels video, we talked a little bit about how there is a channel limit on Discord. There's only so many channels you can make in one server. So part of the impetus for this rule is also to make sure that the server doesn't just balloon with many, many empty channels that people are never planning on replying to or closing the threads for. If we keep up with it, then we don't have to make so many channels because people will be forced to progress their threads and get to the end of them or drop them. So everything we've talked about, essentially the goal is making sure that the roleplay flows well on the platform of Discord. Because Discord wasn't originally created for roleplay groups, even though it's used for lots of them nowadays, we need to do a couple of things to, of course, make Discord play nice with the way that we want to roleplay. Now, my roleplay is very much a para roleplay with adults that take their time to reply, and it's more of a play-by-post type of structure, so that's where my rules are coming from. But if you have a faster-paced roleplay or a more chat-based roleplay, you might have totally different rules. So when you're making your rules for Discord in your roleplay, you just need to think about what is it that the platform does, and what rules do I need to make the platform do the roleplay in the way that I want it to. So with that being said, do you guys use any of the rules that I've talked about that I use? Do you maybe have your own set? I'm really curious because every roleplay, of course, is run slightly differently with slightly different goals. So let me know down below. And remember to like if you like this video, comment down below with any questions that you have, subscribe for new videos, click the bell for notifications, all the links to my social media down in the doobly-doo. Thank you so much for watching and make it a great day.